I think that definitely second generation TKIs have introduced new concepts in the treatment of CML. First of all, what we know is that they are able to suppress some of the early progressions that are still affecting CML patients. Although now the general overall survival is very good and similar to that of a control population, however, few unfortunate cases are still progressing. And this is a big problem that we have to solve. And part of this problem has been solved by the introduction of the second generation TKIs, which are more potent and able to suppress some of the clones which are resistant to the imatinib therapy. The second very important point for second generation TKIs, they induce a faster and deeper molecular response. And this is something which is becoming more and more important, even in patients who do not have a high risk of progression, because once that they have reached a very deep molecular response and maintained this response for a certain period of time, they can try to discontinue the therapy and to reach the so-called treatment-free remission, which is a condition very, very similar, and after a while, I would say absolutely identical to a true cure of the disease. And this is why second generation TKI have introduced a big advancement from the practical and from the conceptual point of view to the treatment of the disease.